Now we'll talk about next circuit, that is binary adder subtractor. So using full adder circuit, we can implement both adder and subtractor. Okay, now so 4-bit binary adder subtractor, 4-bit binary adder subtractor. So the figure is very simple one. So we need 4 full adder circuit. A3, A2, A1, A0. So this is A0, A1, A2, A3. So it is full adder circuit. Clear? And we need XOR circuit for that. B0, B1, B2 and B3. We need one control circuit through which you can control this one, say this is C. And another input, say, so this is A3, we need B3. Okay, so this is A2, connect with this. This is what? B2. Connect with this. This is A1. We need B1. This is A0. We need to connect A0. Okay. And you just connect this one. So in a full adder circuits, 3 inputs are there. 1, 2, 3, and 2 outputs are there. Say output 0 and the next carry output 1 and the next carry output 2 and the next carry output 3 and the next carry, which is C4, or you can assume it is O4. Okay, so full adder circuit, already you know the full adder circuit. So in full adder circuit, you can see here, in full adder circuit, 3 inputs are there, A, B, C, and 2 outputs are there, S and C. Now, we can see, so if C is equal to 0, this particular circuit acts as an adder. And if C is equal to 1, this particular same circuit will act as a subtractor. Okay, and how it is possible? So before that, we just see the truth table of the XOR circuit. Okay. Now already you know the truth table of this XOR circuit, so we can see, just recap this one. So 0, 0, 0, 1, 1, 0, 1, 1. So 2 input are there, A and B. And the Z will be, so it is be 0, 1, 1, 0. Okay. Now you can see here, this is what XOR circuit, truth table of the XOR circuit. Now you can see here, if B is equal to 0, Z will be the same as A. If B is equal to 0, Z will be same as A. That means no change. But if B is equal to 1, then Z will be the complement of A. If B is equal to 1, Z will be the complement of A. So 1 to 0, 0 to 1. So if B is equal to 0, Z is equal to A. And if B is equal to 1, then Z is equal to complement of A. Okay. Now how it is possible? Suppose we want to add two number A plus B. Suppose say 6 plus 3. So 6 plus 3, answer is what? It is 9. Now 6 is what? 6 is nothing but our 4-bit number 0, 1, 1, 0, and 3 means what? 0, 0, 1, 1. Clear? Now if C is equal to 0, that means c is equal to 0, c is equal to 0, so this will be what, 0. And a and b is what, this is what, a0, a1, a2, a3. So a0, a1, a2, a3 will be what, 0, 1, 1, 0. So 0, okay, 1, 1, 0. And b will be b0, b1, b2, b3, so 0, 0, 1, 1. So 0, 0, 1, 1. And c is equal to 0, since c is equal to 0 means what? Here it will be 0, 0, 0, 0, 0. Now you can see here, if any one of the input, say you can check this one. So if it is b and if it is a, so if b is equal to 0, this will be a. That means what, if any one input is 0, output will be the same as a. Clear? So if this is 0, the output will be the of this particular XOR is what, same as b, that will be 0 here, here same 0, here same 0, here it is what, 1, here if it, since it is 0, same as 1, here it is 1, okay, and if it is 0, same as 1, 0, and since c is equal to 0, this is also 0, so 1 plus 0 plus 0, summation is 1, and carry will be 0. So you can add this one, 0 plus 1, 1, carry 0, 1 plus 1, 0, carry 1, 1 plus 1, 0, carry 1, 1 plus 1 plus 0, so sum 1, carry 0. So our answer will be what, 1, 0, 0, 1. So this is nothing but our 9 answer. Okay, you can check. So 0 plus 0, 1 plus 0 plus 0, it is 1, carry 0, 1 plus 1 plus 0, summation is 0, carry 1. 1 plus 1, summation is 0, carry 1. 0 plus 0 plus 1, summation is 1, carry 0. So the answer is 1, 0, 0, 1. Okay? Okay, now so that means what, if C is equal to 0, it is working as the adder circuit. Now if what will happen if C is equal to 1? So if C is equal to 1, so see if C is equal to 1, here it will be what, 1? Now you want to perform subtraction 6 minus 3. So here we have to use 2's complement. So we can see here 0, 1, 1, 0. So 0, 1, 1, 0. 2's complement of 0, 0, 1, 1 is nothing but our 1, 0, 1, 1. Okay. So this is what 2's complement. In if you add this one, so 1, 1, 1 plus 1, 0, carry 1, 1 plus 1, 0, carry 1. You have to discard this one. So this is what, this is 6 and this is 3, so 6 minus 3, answer will be 3. So 0, 1, 1 is nothing but our 3. We can check this one. So 6 minus 3, so 0, 6, 6 means what, 0, 1, 1, 0. So 0, 1, 1, 0. This is what, A. B is what, 1, 1, 0, 1. B is what? B is what, 0, 0, 1, 1. So 0, 0, 0, 1, 1. Now what will happen? Now if C is equal to 1, if C is equal to 1 means what? Here input, another input is what? That is also 1. Here it is 1, 1 and 1. And we have seen here, so if B is equal to 1, if B is equal to 1, the output will be what? Complement of this. So output will be, if b is equal to 1, output will be complement of the a. So here, since c is equal to 1, that means all here, all another inputs are 1. So if it is 1, so complement of here, so 0, complement of 0 is what? It is 1. Complement of 0, it is 1. Complement of 1, it is 0. Complement of 1, it is 0. Okay? Now, here c is equal to 1. Now, perform the addition operation. So 0 plus 0 plus 1, answer is 1, carry 0. Then 0 plus 1 plus 0, sum is 1, carry 0. Next 1 plus 1 plus 0, sum 0, carry 1. Next 1 plus 0 plus 1, 1 plus 0 plus 1, sum 0, carry 1. And we have to discard this particular carry. because we are subtracting this one. So the answer is what? 0, 0, 1, 1. 0, 0, 1, 1. So that is this 3. So just we have seen that if C is equal to 0, it is working as adder circuit. And if C is equal to 1, it is working as subtractor circuit. So this is the design of 4-bit binary adder subtractor. Okay, and that is in this video. Thank you very much.